No mod, no DLC, viewer challenge. Let's go. So, I just checked to see if we actually made any pallets, and we haven't yet, but we're not too far off. So, let's go and do some other stuff, like contracts. It's the only thing that we can really do right now. So, time to check what's happening. We've got one all the way down here, and we pick up somewhere around there, and it's a good amount of money, but oh, no. Potatoes. It's going to take a while. So I'm going to get this potato thing to go down there by itself, and I'm going to grab this and get down there. While I'm doing that, I'm actually going to be thinking about the fact that I can do more than one contract at once, and turns out we actually have a bit of luck in this area, because when I open up the contracts, we're going to see that there is another potato contract. And the good thing about this is that vehicles can only be used for contracts. Thing is that the contracts are also able to be used with each other's contracts. So this is going to make it easier. I was pointing out there that the tiger can actually take one more row out than this one. But I don't think that the AI actually takes advantage of that. So it's a bit of a loss. I think it's a little bit more expensive to go for the tiger rather than the one that they're currently using. And as I mentioned, I don't think the AIs take advantage that the tiger does one extra row. It's time to get this started, and the AI looks like it's only done a small amount. So gonna try to get that going again, and as you can see, that's one more row that the tiger would get done than that one wouldn't. So, but those things are set up, so let's pick up another contract and get another decent amount of money with baling. Now, because I've got my own tractor, it can actually help in this. I had to actually look where I have to go, because this is my first time playing on Elms Creek. I've only played on No Man's Land and Rennaboo, so certainly interesting to see the beginning map. But here we go, we've reset our tractor, we're checking on how full the potato was. Now we're just going to be transporting these back and forth, except this is full. And this is sort of what contracting is going to be like, or at least this is how I like to play the game. I like to have multiple things happening at once, have the AI doing it all, and I'm just sort of like helping out just that little bit. So we're kind of stuck in here, so we've got to get out and unload, which luckily we just hit that 100% right at the end there. Made it out without damaging any crops, which it's important to try and get as much as possible, considering that we also get paid for any extras. So I thought, you know, I would take out a bit and then turn around and start back up from its old spot, but that ain't happening. So let's try and get this little small amount done while I continue to transport the rest of the equipment into this baling area. Now, resetting, because you're allowed to do that. More equipment, let's go. Looks like I've got to find out where we actually deposit this, because the trailer is basically full. Luckily, it's like right here, which is just fantastic. The funny thing is that just take note of how many trailers we're actually going to be putting into such a small building. Made me giggle a little bit, especially when we got right near the end of the day. I am obviously voicing over the fast recording. I'm not able to talk this slowly and make it make sense for the time lapse. So, yes, I'm actually rewatching everything that I've done, trying to remember what I've done, and then, yeah, doing the voiceover. And if I ever fall short, I will just fill it up with music. I enjoy the fact that they gave me the fast track here, because it does go fast, is the name, as the name suggests. I tried to get it to deliver it by itself, but it looks like we're just going to have to do destinations. So it is back to the spot that it first stopped, and away we go. Now, delivering this for the final thing, and then I believe I start up the tendering. Now, it's interesting that you normally have to leave it for days to dry, but when you think of the time scale of this, of 1 month being crammed into 24 hours, just leaving the grass sitting there for a minute, I wonder what that would actually extend out to. I'll probably work it out one day and mention it in a different video, because, yeah, you think 24 hours is... that's a day is going to be less than an hour is 1 day. So then, yeah, 24 divided by 60 or whatever. So every 3 minutes is like an hour, something like that. Just quick mathing that, really. Not working it out properly. But so, yeah, if you leave it in real time, in game time for 3 minutes. Wait, we wanted a day, didn't we? So yeah, if you leave it... wow, rambling. Okay, yes. If you leave it for 2 hours in game, then that would be more than 2 days simulated for the month. So, yeah, but I don't think you'd be able to really be able to, like, convert that properly, and every time that the time changes, it would be certainly more difficult. So, at least it's not, which, I mean, it's probably something that will happen later, is where you've got a mower on the front and a tender on the back. Wait, what are they called? The grass flippers on the back. trying to think quick, talk quick, not working too well. So here I kind of think that because there is grass on the outside, I might actually be able to sneak in just a little bit more grass from the outside into this contract and make just a little bit more money. But I'll find out later that it's not as easy as it, as I thought it could be, should be. But I still did it, so, you know, we did get there. More unloading, more travelling. That's kind of going to be what the day is. And we actually take 2 days to do all three of these contracts. But at the end, it is a good haul. But I think that's pretty much going to be it for me talking, because we're just going to be jumping back and forth through all of these, getting everything done, sending out the AI and dumping the loads. So that's half of this video of me talking. We will spend the other half with the music, the YouTube approved music, that is. And I think you'll find I've only got one good turnaround, but maybe. Either way, you viewers will see it. And I hope that if anyone is challenging me, that they'll let me know down in the comments. And I'll be able to click on your... Oh, and if you are challenging me and video recording it, I would love to see that as well. But yes, enough rambling. That's more than half of the video, so I will leave the rest up to a time lapse. Not a time lapse, the music. Thank you.
chasing stars and holding you. I can't see the end, but we'll see it through.
End of today. We got quite a lot done. We've had to stop our workers where they are so that they're not running overnight, and we are going to be continuing this the next day. So thanks for watching. I really hope that somebody out there is competing against me and will let me know in the comments. Otherwise, I hope you enjoyed the video, and I will hopefully see you next time.